Another day, another terrible traffic jam for drivers trying to make it through the heart of downtown Boston. John Keller joins us now. And John, really, this is becoming all too familiar. You can see it just that's going to mess up your whole day.
Yeah, it certainly is and does, Jonathan. And since it opened in 2003, the O'Neill Tunnel has suffered a litany of woes, including leaky walls and corroded light fixtures. But one problem appears to be chronic, a roadway design that has turned out to be a fertile breeding ground for traffic clogging accidents.
Commonly in the tunnel, we have people who are either driving slightly too fast or too close to the car in front of them.
And that appears to be what happened this morning inside the tunnel, a common scene in a multi-billion dollar facility that has long been a traffic safety nightmare. A review of accident data a few years after the O'Neill Tunnel opened found there were 22 times more accidents there than in the Sumner and Callahan tunnels combined. And in the years since, the tip has remained an accident factory.
I certainly can't drive because I've got a flat tire. And
his truck got clipped a few hours after this morning's pileup.
People are trying to make split-second decisions on which lane to be in, and that seems to be confusing.
A problem caused by confusing signs and exits that come up on you too fast.
I have trouble navigating the exits. It comes on and off so quick. I see people having trouble too. They're not sure whether they go south or north.
Right.
And the merge is very difficult.
Everybody in Massachusetts thinks the speed limit says plus 10, and it doesn't.
The state stop transportation official says they've tried to clean up the mess, upgrading signage and lighting. But it seems the Big Dig's troubled legacy just keeps on giving. You inherited an engineering nightmare, didn't you?
Well, it's a challenging piece of roadway.
Now, Secretary DePaola says they're thinking of putting rumble strips at the entrances to the tunnel to slow down speeders, but they don't want to lower the speed limit below the current 45 miles per hour for fear of creating the sort of backups the project was supposed to eliminate in the first place. So win you lose you lose. That's the legacy of the Big Dig.
I actually think the anxiety of getting caught in an accident makes some people drive faster to get through the tunnel. I think it exacerbates the whole
thing. I think it's the same reason why some nuts around here drive fast in the snow, so that not too many flakes will fall on their car and they'll make it home safely. They obviously